Good morning, everyone. Today we are going to talk about the CM550W 5G router. We are going to show you how to insert the SIM card and how to connect the antennas. The SIM card cover is at the back of the unit, so we need to remove the cover. And the SIM card size is the standard size SIM or the mini size. Do not use the micro or the nano size because it may damage the unit. So it needs to be the standard size SIM. And we insert it in SIM slot 1. This is the first SIM. And in SIM slot 2, this is the second SIM. Now, why do you need two SIMs? Some people use two SIMs. If you have a Telstra SIM, for example, in SIM slot 1 and Optus in SIM slot 2, they can act as in failover redundancy. Most people use a single SIM, so in this case just insert it in SIM slot 1, which is the lower slot or the one adjacent to the PCB board. Now at the front of the unit, as you can see, we have four antenna sockets in the middle, and they are for 5G and 4G, and two antenna sockets on the outer, and they are for Wi-Fi. Now the Wi-Fi is the dual band 2.4 gigahertz and 5 gigahertz concurrent Wi-Fi. The unit comes with four antennas for 5G, and they are the pedal antennas 5G, 4G and 3G multiband, as well as two Wi-Fi antennas. They cover the 2.4 gigahertz and the 5 gigahertz. I'll show you how to connect one of these antennas. So this is the 5G antenna. We remove the antenna socket cover and we screw the antenna like so. Now we need to connect all four antennas because the unit supports MIMO 4x4. It's different from the 4G routers that support MIMO 2x2. So with 5G, it is very important to connect all four antennas. If you feel that the signal is weak and you want to position your antenna next to the window or high on a cabinet, the unit comes with a magnetic base with 3 meter cable, which is this unit here. So what you do is you unscrew the antenna from the router and you connect on the magnetic base instead. And the other end connects to the router. Connect all four of them like this, and you position this magnetic base next to the window. If you still have a weak signal, we recommend having a high gain external antenna. Now I'll talk quickly about the ports on this unit. As you can see at the front of the unit, we have four Ethernet ports, and there are 4 gigabit ports. They are for LAN connectivity, so you can connect your PC or an IP camera, for example. One of these ports, LAN 1, is LAN/WAN, so you can connect NBN, for example, and configure the unit in failover redundancy. In the middle here, we have a DIO board. The unit comes with a DIO terminal block. It's got two digital input and two digital output. Here we have the LEDs for signal strength and power. And to the side here we have a terminal block for power and for serial connectivity. The unit comes with this terminal block for power, and you can see the power cord is connected to VCC and ground. The unit takes a DC source between 7 volt DC and 32 volt DC. So if you have a battery and a solar panel, you can wire it directly onto the VCC and ground. Just make sure you have the correct polarity so you do not damage the unit. But the unit comes also with an AC adapter, which is 240 volt AC and 12 volt DC. So you connect the DC jack to the power cord and plug it onto the power point. Now, to the side, we have serial connectivity. We have RS232 to the side, and you have here RX, TX, and ground, and in the middle you have RS485. Finally, if you want to mount the unit on a DIN rail, the unit comes with a DIN rail bracket. You can screw it at the back and mount it on a DIN rail. So this is a quick overview of the CM550W. We talked about how to insert the SIM card, how to connect the antennas, and we talked about the various ports on the unit. Thank you for watching, and we will see you in the next video.